Now it's time for Drama on Three and two plays by the acclaimed playwright and screenwriter Nick Payne. In 2009, Nick Payne won the prestigious George Devine Award for the Most Promising Playwright, and since then he's been a prolific writer for both stage and screen. The first of the plays you're about to hear is Constellations, which opened at the Royal Court Theatre in 2012 and went on to win the Evening Standard Best Play Award. It was nominated for the Olivier Award for Best New Play. The second is Elegy, which was performed at the Donmar Warehouse in London in 2016 and was also nominated for the Olivier Award for Best New Play. Both plays contain strong language from the start. And here's the writer, Nick Payne.
Constellation started out as a play about beekeeping. I met a beekeeper based in London and I followed him round for a day or so and he showed me around some of his hives. I found the process and the craft of beekeeping really interesting and not at all what I'd expected. Pretty quickly though I realised I had no idea how to put bees or hives or beekeeping more generally on stage. I assumed it would be a bit of a health and safety nightmare. So I shelved all my beekeeping notes and ideas until further notice. Around the same time, I stumbled across, completely by chance, a documentary called The Elegant Universe, presented by Professor Brian Greene, based on his book of the same name. In the final episode of the documentary, Professor Greene talked about the concept or the idea or the theory that we might in fact be living in a multiverse, basically a kind of never-ending stream of parallel universes. My dad had not long died, relatively suddenly, and so I suppose I warmed to the idea of the multiverse, mostly because I liked the idea of a different or parallel version of me spending time with a different or parallel version of my dad. For reasons I'm not entirely sure of, I decided to dig out my old beekeeping material and see what would happen if I kind of mushed it all together with my fledgling research into contemporary theoretical physics. Constellations, then, explores the many and varied possible lives of a single couple thrown together by chance. When the play was first performed, people tended to focus primarily on the science or the scientific ideas they felt the play was wrestling with. But really, at the time, and I suppose all these years later, I'm inclined to think it's a play about the impossibility of having to say goodbye to someone you love. This is Constellations with Gugu Mbatha-Raw as Marianne and George Mackay as Roland.
Do you know why it's impossible to lick the tips of your elbows? They hold the secret to immortality. So if you could lick them, there's a chance you'd be able to live forever. But if everyone did it, if everyone could actually lick the tips of their elbows, then there'd be chaos. Because you can't just go on living and living and living.
I'm in a relationship. So, yeah.
Do you know why it's impossible to lick the tips of your elbows? They hold the secret to immortality. So if you could lick them, there's a chance you'd be able to live forever. But if everyone did it, if everyone could actually lick the tips of their elbows, then there'd be chaos. Because you can't just come on living and living and living.
I've just come out of a really serious relationship. So, yeah.
I was just making conversation.
Sure.
Just trying to start a conversation.
No, sure. But still.
Do you know why it's impossible to lick the tips of your elbows? They hold the secret to immortality. So if you could lick them, there's a chance you'd be able to live forever. But if everyone did it, if everyone could actually lick the tips of their elbows, then there'd be chaos. Because you can't just go on living and living and living.
All right.
Try it.
What's that?
Your elbows. Try licking them.
I'm all right.
Like this. I'm Marianne.
Roland.
Thank God the rain sailed off.
Yeah.
Nothing worse than a soggy barbecue.
Yeah.
Soggy sausages. Would you like a drink?
I'm all right. My wife's actually just gone to get me a beer.
Try it.
What's that?
Your elbows. Try licking them. Like this.
Let's see what you mean. I'm rolling.
Marianne.
Shame about the rain.
Nothing worse than a soggy barbecue.
So are you a friend of Jane's or...?
No, Jane, yeah. We were at college together.
Right.
Yourself?
My wife used to work with Jane.
Hmm. Your elbows, try licking them.
I see what you mean. I'm rolling.
Marianne.
Shame about the rain.
Nothing worse than a soggy barbecue.
So are you... Are you a friend of Jane's, or...?
Who's Jane?
Jane's the... She's the lady having the barbecue.
Oh, right. Christ, no. I was just walking past and saw a load of free booze and sausages. I'm joking.
Right.
Jane and I were at college together. How about you?
I play football with Tom.
Tom?
Jane's brother-in-law. Bluey-green T-shirt.
Ah, yes.
Do you want a drink?
I'm fine. Thanks.
So, what do you do for a living?
I work at Sussex University.
Right. Great.
Yourself?
I'm a beekeeper.
Really?
Yeah, yeah.
You're really a beekeeper?
I'm really a beekeeper.
I fucking love honey.
Oh, yeah?
Spoon, jar of honey, heaven.
What sort of honey do you normally go for?
Too embarrassed.
How do you mean?
Too embarrassed to tell you.
Why is that?
I like Tesco. The really dirty stuff, the prison stripe stuff.
That's all right.
Really?
Of course.
I'm not putting honest, hard-working beekeepers out of business.
Wouldn't have thought so.
Do you think I'm a honey philistine?
Some of the supermarket stuff's all right.
Really?
Yeah, some of it's fine, yeah.
So, and I mean, don't take this the wrong way, but, I mean...
What?
Are you...
Go on.
You... I mean, do you make a living?
I do, yeah.
From beekeeping?
From beekeeping.
How does it...
Well, I used to work for a friend of mine in Wiltshire.
Very nice.
After a while, though, decided I wanted to go into business on my own. But my girlfriend, or ex-girlfriend...
Sorry for your loss.
What's that?
No, I was making a...
Right.
Sorry for your loss, as in...
Right.
It was just...
No.
Anyway, you were...
Yeah, no, so she, my ex, she wanted to move to London. So we got this one-bed place in Tower Hamlets.
No wonder you broke up with her. I'd have broken up with her if she made me leave Wiltshire for fucking Tower Hamlets.
I'm still living there, actually.
Lovely curries.
There wasn't any room for bees.
I see.
We didn't have a garden.
Bummer.
One day I was up on the roof and I realised it was perfect. So I tidied up a bit and I got my first hive.
Amazing.
Went from one to two, from two to four. We went away. Me and Laura, we went away to Spain. And when we got back, we found that the flat had been raided.
Raided?
I used to keep the honey in bin bags. You know, those black plastic bin liners?
Yes.
Didn't have a lot of money at the time, so the bin bags were just a cheap alternative. When we were away, though, one of the neighbours called the police. Thought I was brewing up smack or something. They probably went for it. The police. They kicked the front door in, turned the flat upside down, and they confiscated all these bin bags filled with the most amazing honey and honeycomb.
Did that really happen?
Yeah.
You used to keep honey in bin bags?
Yeah.
Roland, I don't think that I can go back to work.
Have they told you that?
They're great.
You've told them then?
Not yet.
But you're going to?
I think so.
You haven't said any of this to them?
They've said whatever I want.
So what about part-time?
I don't know the point.
You mean the point of going part-time?
Either I'm walking or I'm... Either I'm... Walker, I either do it or I don't. Scares me.
Work?
Stopping.
Stopping work scares you.
What will I do?
We'll go away. We can do whatever we want.
I don't...
I'm being serious.
I don't...
I mean it.
I don't... We can't. I have to... have to... make a... I have to have a choice. Control.
You want me to leave?
Not in a bad way, but yeah.
Have I done something wrong?
No.
Have I said something? Have I offended you?
No.
I thought we'd had a nice evening.
We did.
Coming back here was your suggestion.
I know, but on reflection...
Do you want to come inside, you said?
I know, but now I've changed my mind. I'm allowed to change my mind, aren't I?
If I'm allowed to ask why, sure.
I'd just rather not get into it.
Can you at least tell me if it's me? I'm not saying specifically, just generally speaking.
I'm just going through some things at the moment. And you're right, we had a lovely evening, and you're right, it was my idea to come back here, but as soon as we stepped inside, I just started thinking.
You want me to leave?
Not in a bad way, but yeah.
Have I done something wrong?
No.
Have I said something? Have I offended you?
No.
Then I don't understand.
I'm not asking you to understand, I'm asking you to leave.
Bit fucking rich, isn't it?
I'm sorry.
This was your idea.
Charming.
I'm just saying.
Okay.
It's rude.
Yeah, I'd like you to leave now.
I should probably make a move.
You don't... I mean, don't feel you have to.
I've got a really early start.
How early's early?
6.
You could... I mean, you could... Not in a, like, welcome to my lair way or anything, but if you wanted, you could... Stay.
I should probably head back.
Well... Look, I mean... Thanks for a really lovely evening.
Likewise, yeah.
We should... I mean, whenever you're free, we should think about...
Definitely, yeah.
The lair thing was just a joke, by the way.
Come again?
So if it just falls out, you wouldn't have to stay in my bed. Stop talking, Marianne. Not in a bad way, but yeah.
Have I said something wrong?
No.
Have I said something...
No.
I thought we'd had a nice evening.
We did.
Coming back here was your suggestion.
No, I know, but on reflection...
Do you want to come inside, you said?
I know, but now I've changed my mind. I'm allowed to change my mind, aren't I? I just rather not get into it.
I went on another date a couple of weeks ago. Almost exactly the same thing happened. So I'm more than happy to leave you to it, but if it's me...
It's not.
I'm not saying you have to be specific.
It's not you.
If you had some feedback...
Feedback?
Oh, feedback's not right, but...
Okay, look. I'm just going through some things at the moment. My mother... She's been ill for a really long time. And... I can't tell whether I want you to stay because I want you to stay or whether I just don't want to go to sleep on my own.
I'm really sorry.
Why don't we just speak in a week or so?
A friend of mine said to me when I told him that I was going on a date, he said, what does she do?
And what did you say?
I said, I don't really know, but I think it's something to do with space. And when we were talking about your job earlier on, I was nodding along pretty much the entire time. But when we stepped through your front door, I realised I hadn't really understood a single thing you'd said.
Most of my time is spent sitting in front of a computer.
Right.
Analysing data.
Right.
Cosmic microwave background readings.
Okay.
Radiation left over from the Big Bang.
Right.
Cosmology. Theoretical early universe cosmology.
I said, I don't really know, but I think it's something to do with space. And when we were talking about your job earlier on, I was nodding along pretty much the entire time. But when we stepped through your front door, I realised I hadn't really understood a single thing you'd said.
Most of my time is spent sitting in front of a computer.
Right.
Analysing data.
Right.
Quantum cosmology.
Right.
Do you know much about theoretical physics?
Pass.
Quantum mechanics?
Pass.
Quantum mechanics focuses on the quantum realm. Atoms, molecules.
Right.
On nuclear and atomic scales, gravity is pretty much insignificant. But in terms of general relativity, it's vital.
Okay.
So you have these two theories that are completely at odds with one another. Relativity covers the sun, the moon, the stars. While quantum mechanics takes care of molecules, quarks, atoms, that sort of thing. We've effectively asked the same question twice and come up with two completely different answers.
This is really sexy, by the way.
The point being...
I had a really amazing time tonight and I'd really like to spend the night with
you. But...
With you. I'd really like to spend the night.
But now we've got string theory. Or to be more specific, we've got lots of different string theories.
If you'd rather I didn't stay, you'd just have to say...
And the exciting thing about string theory is that it potentially bridges the gap between relativity and...
You haven't answered either of my questions.
A byproduct of every single one of these theories, almost entirely by accident, is the possibility that we're part of a multiverse. Despite our best efforts, there are certain microscopic observations that just cannot be predicted absolutely.
Now, potentially, one way of explaining this is to draw the conclusion that at any given moment, several outcomes can coexist simultaneously.
This is genuinely turning me on. You do realise that?
In the quantum multiverse, every choice, every decision you've ever and never made exists in an unimaginably vast ensemble of parallel universes.
Everything.
Everything.
Everything I've ever done.
Everything you've ever and never done.
But if everything I'm ever going to do already exists, then what's the point in me?
Well...
What's the point in me even?
Well...
Do you know what I'm saying?
No, totally, but let's say that ours really is the only universe that exists. There's only one unique me and one unique you. If that were true, then there could only ever really be one choice. But if every possible future exists, then the decisions we do and don't make will determine which of these futures we actually end up experiencing. Imagine rolling a dice 6,000 times.
Everything.
Everything.
Everything I've ever done.
Everything you've ever and never done.
But if everything I'm ever going to do already exists, then what's the point in me?
There isn't.
What?
In none of our equations do we see any sign whatsoever of any evidence of free will.
In your...
We're just particles.
Speak for yourself.
We're just particles governed by a series of very particular laws being knocked around all over the place.
You make it sound so glamorous.
Most of my time is spent sitting in front of a computer typing in numbers. It's not very interesting.
Okay.
Look, I've had a really enjoyable evening.
No, yeah.
I haven't really made my mind up, though, whether or not I'd like you to stay. I've got quite a bit on at the moment, and we were having a really lovely time, and I thought it would be really nice to invite you back. But I just want to be clear that I'm not massively interested in sleeping with you.
It's all right. You don't have to...
I just sort of rather get into bed and go to sleep. But I'm completely happy to go and get you a sleeping bag and a couple of towels.
Okay.
But, I mean, just to be clear, I'm not being coy. I'm not sort of saying no to sex, but yes to all the other stuff. We're going to go to sleep separately, and then we're going to wake up, and then we're going to have some toast. Or, I mean, whatever. You don't have to have toast.
Floor's fine. Honestly.
I'm so tired, Roland. Before people had face... Before they had... Face... Face... Before they... Fuck!
Okay.
God.
God?
People's lives were their own. Before... It became skin. Skin, it became skin.
Skin.
Mum wasn't scared of dying. She was scared of being kept alive, you know?
Yes.
That wasn't what scared her.
I understand.
It's not just speaking.
Okay, now I don't understand.
Reading. I'm having trouble. Numbers, words on the page. I don't know how to explain it. Typing. Typing as well.
In what way?
I know the word. I know the word I'm trying to type, but I don't know the letters. None of the letters seem right. Ria.
You don't need to finish.
I want to.
I think I know what you're trying to say.
How? How can you know what I'm trying to say? Most of the time, I don't even know what I'm trying to say.
You're right. I was being polite because I don't want you to wear yourself out.
Maybe we should get me a notepad to hang around my neck?
What?
Kidding.
Mary fucking hell.
Roland, I don't think that I can go back to work.
All right.
Where have you been?
Pub.
I sent you a text.
I know.
Why didn't you text me back?
Don't know.
What does that mean?
It means I don't know. It means I didn't think it was urgent.
I didn't know where you were.
I just told you.
Now? You just told me now, but I wanted to know...
I was playing tennis. I was playing tennis with Tony, and then we went to the pub. What's wrong? I'm sorry. What is it? What's wrong?
Roland, I'm really sorry.
What is it?
James and I had sex.
James?
From work.
The centre parting? You mean the bloke with the centre parting?
Yes.
When?
There have been a few. A few times.
How many's a few?
I'd rather we didn't get into who did what to whom.
How many's a few, Mary?
Six? Maybe seven?
Spread out? Were the six or seven times you had sex spread out over a particular period of time?
Yes.
Are you together, then? Do you want to be together?
I don't know.
Is he moving in?
Of course not, Roland. Of course he's not.
Do you want me to move out? When do you want me to move out?
There's no rush.
That's it, then, is it?
Where have you been?
Pub.
I sent you a text.
I know.
Why didn't you text me back?
Don't know.
What does that mean?
It means I don't know. It means I didn't think it was urgent.
I didn't know where you were.
I just told you.
Now? You just told me now, but I wanted to...
I was playing tennis with Tony, and then we went to the pub. What's wrong? I'm sorry. What is it? What's wrong?
Roland, I'm really sorry.
What? What is it?
James and I had sex.
James?
From work.
Dandruff? You mean the bloke with dandruff?
He doesn't... Yes.
When?
There've been a few times.
How many's a few?
I'd rather we didn't get into who did what to whom.
How many's a few, Mary?
Six. Maybe seven.
Spread out?
What?
Were the six or seven times you had sex spread out over a particular period of time?
Yes.
Are you together, then? Do you want to be together? Mary, do the two of you...
I don't know!
Is he moving in? Where do you want me to move out?
There's no rush.
How old is he?
He's 24.
24?
Yes.
He's a child!
He's 24, Roland!
Where do you have sex?
All sorts of places.
What does that mean?
It means we've had sex in more than one place.
Here?
Roland, of course we've not
had... His place?
Yes.
Where does he live?
Brighton.
You have sex in the daytime, then?
Yes.
In the fucking daytime?
Sometimes, yes. Oh,
during lunch, is it? So when's he going to move in? Mary? When's he going to move...
There's no date.
But he is going to move in.
Hopefully.
Am I boring?
What?
Do I bore you?
Of course not.
We don't talk about space enough, is that it?
It's nothing to do with work.
That doesn't make it better, you know? If you'd said yes, it's because we don't talk about space enough, it might have made a bit more sense. I kick myself for not making more of an effort, but at least it'd make a bit more sense.
There's no linear explanation, I'm afraid.
Where have you been?
Work.
I sent you a text.
I know.
You've not texted me back.
I know.
What does that mean?
It means I know that you sent me a text.
I didn't know where you were.
Why are you being so touchy? I was at work and then I missed the 7:37 and then the 8:04 didn't turn up. What's wrong? What's the matter?
Mary, I'm really sorry, but I had sex with Alison O'Connor. Tuesday the week before last.
Alison O'Connor?
Yeah.
Thought she was going bold.
What?
She's going bold, Roland. She's going fucking bold. Well, how many times? How many times did you have sex with her, Roland?
Once.
Once?
Tuesday, the week before last, yeah.
What were you doing? What were the two of you doing?
I was helping her set up a hive.
Is this a fucking joke?
No.
You were helping her set up a hive?
Yes.
Speak up.
I said yes. I was helping
her. Is it serious?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I need some time to think about it.
Oh, you need some time to think about it.
Preferably, yes.
Does this mean you're moving out?
Up to you, really.
If it were up to me, Roland, you wouldn't have fucked fucking Alison O'Connor.
All right.
I beg your pardon?
Calm down.
Fuck you, actually. I've never been happier living with you. Just so you know.
That doesn't make it any better, you know? If you said yes, it's because we don't talk about space enough. It might have made a bit more sense. I kick myself for not making more of an effort, but at least it'd make a bit more sense.
There's no straightforward explanation, I'm afraid.
Don't make me leave.
Roland.
This is the best thing that's ever happened to me. I'm serious.
You'll be fine.
I don't know what I'm going to do.
You can move back to Tower Hamlets.
Is that meant to be a joke?
Of course it's not. I just meant you've got lots you can do.
I don't care.
Come on.
I don't.
You're being melodramatic.
How long have you been waiting to tell me?
A week.
I was going to propose.
Roland.
I need some time to think about it.
Oh, you need some time to think about it?
Preferably, yes.
Does this mean you're moving out?
Up to you, really.
If it were up to me, Roland, you wouldn't have fucked
All
fucking...
right.
I beg your pardon?
I don't want to fight.
Tough.
What?
I said tough.
Mary, come on. I'm telling you because I regret it, not because I want
to... You regret something once. You don't regret it and then keep doing it.
What's the likelihood you might be able to forgive me?
Where have you been?
Pub.
I sent you a text.
I know.
Why didn't you text me back?
Don't know.
What does that mean?
It means, I don't know, it means I didn't think it was urgent.
I didn't know where you were.
I just told you.
Now? You just told me now, but
I was playing tennis. I was playing tennis with Tony and then we went to the pub. What's wrong? I'm sorry. What is it? What's wrong?
Roland, I'm really sorry.
What is it?
James and I had sex. Roland. Did you hear what I just
know.
Said? What?
You had a message from him while you were in the shower. I read it.
Yeah, you need to leave.
Make me.
What?
I said make me.
Mum.
In what way?
Before she died.
Right.
When she said she didn't want any more food.
Yeah.
Do you remember?
I'm not sure we ever really talked about it.
I thought we did.
Bits and pieces, maybe.
Well, she said she wanted them to stop the IV. Did we talk about that?
I think maybe we did, yeah.
They asked me to leave. I went back the next day and she was starting to look like a ghost. It takes an enormous amount of strength when you're like that to keep going. I'm not sure I have it.
You don't know that.
Sinking feeling.
Mary, listen to me.
I'm so tired. Roland. Before people had face. Before they had face, before they fuck.
Okay.
God. People's lives were their own. Before it became skin, it became skin.
Skin.
Mum wasn't scared of dying, she was scared of being kept alive, you know?
Yes.
That wasn't what scared her.
Hello, Marianne.
Roland! Wow! Hi.
Hello.
Yeah.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks.
Oh, good. That's really good.
How about yourself?
I bought some of your honey.
You didn't?
From the Budgeons in Crouch End.
Yeah, right.
They're really great.
I said to the girl on the till, I said, I used to know the man who made this honey.
I read one of your papers.
You did not.
I did. I downloaded it.
Which one did you read?
Something to do with XMM cluster survey.
That's really amazing, Roland.
What did you think of the honey?
Delicious. It was completely delicious. Are you here for the ballroom class?
Yeah. No. Yeah, I am. Yeah.
Really?
Heather's getting married in a couple of months, so...
The PE teacher?
What's that?
He was a PE teacher, wasn't he?
Right. No, I see. They called it a day. New blokes are something or other for the Office of National Statistics.
Wow.
I've been ordered to sort out my two left feet or else. How about you?
Similar, really. Wedding.
Your own, or...?
No, mine. Yep.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
Is your fiancé, is he...
Held up. He's been held up.
Hello, Marianne. It's Roland.
Roland!
Yeah. How are you? I hope I didn't scare you.
No. A bit. Oh. Maybe. I mean, a bit.
Sorry.
Are you here for the ballroom class?
Yeah. No. Yeah, I am, yeah.
Ballroom, really?
Heather's getting married.
Heather?
My sister.
Heather, of course.
I've been ordered to sort out my two left feet or else.
Did you know that I was going to be here?
What? Did I...
Know that I was going to be here?
No. No, of course not.
I'm learning ballroom because I'm getting married, Roland.
No, sure.
In September.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you. What about you? Are you...
I was, but for the moment, no.
Married?
Seeing someone. I was seeing someone, but we broke up, so...
I'm sorry.
No, please. Don't be.
Hello, Roland.
Marianne. Wow, shit. How's it going?
Well, I'm really well. Thanks.
Great. That's really great.
Yourself?
I mean, good, yeah.
I bought some of your honey.
You didn't?
From the Budgeons in Crouch End.
Yeah, right. They're really great.
I said to the girl on the till, I said, I used to know the man who made this for me.
What did she say?
She just stared at me. How is everything? Business-wise?
Oh, good. Yeah, about to start doing pollen.
Pollen?
Yeah, you have to... You scrape it off the legs of the bees and then you grind it down. Really good for you, apparently.
Scraping the legs off bees or pollen?
Had an offer from Tesco, of all people.
For the pollen?
No, just for the honey.
How much for?
Fair whack.
What did you say?
Told them to go fuck themselves. I read one of your papers.
You did not?
I did. I downloaded it.
Which one did you read?
Something about hot subdwarf stars.
Why are you really looking for midget porn on Google?
What's that?
Subdwarf. It was
I gotcha.
That's really amazing, Roland. Thank you.
What did you think of the honey? From Budgeons.
Delicious. It was completely delicious.
It's heather.
Yes.
We cart the bees up to the heather moors every August, one by one.
One by one?
Hives, not bees.
Are you here for the ballroom class?
Yeah. No, yeah. I am, yeah. I'm actually engaged.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah.
Who's the lucky lady?
Alison. Alison, no.
I remember.
How about yourself? Are you...
Just trying to lose a bit of weight. Too many late-night digestive binges. I blame the subdwarfs. The stars. The paper you read.
Heather's getting married in a couple of months, so...
The PE teacher?
What's that?
He was a PE teacher, wasn't he?
Right, no, I see. They called it a day. Yeah. New blokes are something or other for the DVLA.
Wow.
Been ordered to sort out my two left feet or else. How about you?
Similar, really. Wedding.
Your own, or...?
No, God, can you imagine? I'm being a very diligent bridesmaid. We're having some kind of mass Viennese waltz. I'm not sure I fully understand it as yet.
So is this your first lesson?
No, second. You?
First, yeah.
Well done on the comfortable trouser front. I came straight from work. Last week, crotch was like a blazing furnace by the time I got home.
Mary, I'm sorry.
Well done on the comfortable trouser front. I came straight from work. Last week, crotch was like a blazing inferno by the time I got home. Roland, I'm sorry.
What for?
Well done on the comfortable trouser front. I came straight from work. Last week, crotch was like a blazing sauna by the time I got home. I have to say it, because if I don't, I'll feel like a fraud.
Mary.
Let's go for a drink. I don't know what I'm doing here anyway. One drink. And if you never want to see me again, you never have to see me again.
Mary.
Let's go for a drink. I don't know what I'm doing here anyway. One drink. And if you never want to see me again, you never have to see me again.
Mary.
Why don't we go for a drink? I don't know what I'm doing here anyway. One drink. And if you never want to see me again, you never have to see me again.
Mary.
One drink. And if you never want to see me again, you never have to see me again.
Mary.
And if you never want to see me again, you never have to see me again.
I don't really know what to say.
You don't have to say anything.
Oh, I know, but I want to. I want to know what to say to you.
A lot of people apparently never go through with it.
How do you mean?
A lot of people, once they've been given the green knight... Knight... Once they've... A lot of...
It's okay.
They're happy enough knowing it's there.
How do you know that?
It's on the website.
When you say a lot, how many are we talking?
I think it was something like 2/3. Safety net for a lot of people.
And is that how you're feeling about it?
I don't know.
Would I be able to come with you?
Would you want to? Come with me?
Would you want me to come with you?
I keep thinking of Mum.
There are 3 different kinds of bees. The drones, the workers, and a single, solitary queen. The workers are all women. Their job is to forage for honey, pollen, etc. Their lifespan is potentially anywhere between 5 weeks and 6 months, and then they die. Drones exist solely to have sex with the queen. Each hive tends to have around 100 drones. Once they've deposited their sperm, their penis gets ripped off and they die.
Roland.
Honeybees have an unfailing clarity of purpose. Their lives are often intensely short. But in a strange sort of way, I'm jealous of the humble honeybee and their quiet elegance.
Roland, any moment...
If only our existence were that simple.
Any moment...
If only we could understand why it is that we're here and what it is that we're meant to spend our lives doing. I am uncertain when it comes to a great many things. But there is now one thing I am defiantly certain of. Marion Orbell, will you marry me?
Roland, I've got a tutorial. You can't just turn up like this. I mean, it's the middle of the day. There's a lot going on. I need to think about it. I'm sorry. I just really need some space. This is a surprise.
Is it?
It's the middle of the afternoon.
Are you busy?
Is everything...
There's something I'd like to say to you. There are 3 different kinds of bees. The drones, the workers, and a single solitary queen. The workers are all women. Their job is to forage for honey, pollen, etc. Their lifespan is potentially anywhere between 5 weeks and 6 months, and then they die. Drones exist solely to have sex with the queen. Each hive tends to have around 100 drones. Once they've deposited their sperm, their penis gets ripped off and they die. Honeybees have an unfailing clarity of purpose. Their lives are often intensely short. But in a strange sort of way, I am jealous of the humble honeybee and their quiet elegance. If only our existence were that simple. If only we could understand why it is that we're here and what it is that we're meant to spend our lives doing. I am uncertain when it comes to a great many things, but there is now one thing I am defiantly certain of.
Roland, please. Roland, get up. Come on.
Marion or Bell? Will you marry me?
Roland, we talked about this. Come on. This is a surprise.
Is it?
It's the middle of the afternoon.
There's something I'd like to say to you. Oh, shit.
What is it?
Oh, I've left it at home.
What is it?
I've left it at home.
Left what at home, Roland? Roland, is everything all right?
Okay, I'm going to just own up. I came down here because I wanted to... I had this whole speech written out. It took me an absolute age, and it's just thrown me a bit.
Roland, you're sweating.
There's something I'd like to say to you. So, as you know, well, maybe you know, there are three different kinds of bees. There's the drones, there's the workers, and there's the queen. And the drones are all women. Sorry, the workers. The workers are all women. The drones have sex with the queen. But once they've ejaculated, they die. I should have written this down.
Roland.
What I'm trying to say is that bees have a really short life. They have an incredibly short life, and then that's it. Possibly the bit about the lifespan should have come at the start, and I could have moved on.
Is there something...
Do you remember when we first met?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
At that wedding.
What?
John and Ruth's wedding.
We met at a barbecue.
There are three different kinds of bees. The drones, the workers, and a single, solitary queen. The workers are all women. Their job is to forage for honey, pollen, etc. Their lifespan is potentially anywhere between 5 weeks and 6 months. And then they die. Drones exist solely to have sex with the queen. Each hive tends to have around 100 drones. Once they've deposited their sperm, their penis gets ripped off and they die. Honeybees have an unfailing clarity of purpose. Their lives are often intensely short. But in a strange sort of way, I'm jealous of the humble honeybee and their quiet elegance. If only our existence were that simple. If only we could understand why it is that we're here and what it is that we're meant to spend our lives doing. I am uncertain when it comes to a great many things. But there is now one thing I am defiantly certain of. Marion or Bell. Will you marry me?
Okay.
Really?
Yeah. Really. Where is that speech from? Was it from a book? It was, wasn't it? Was it Ted Hooper? It was, wasn't it?
Bits.
Oh, I've got a fucking tutorial.
I'll see you at home.
Is that okay?
Of course.
Thank you. If you're serious, you write to them.
Meaning what?
Outline why they ought to be taking you seriously.
And if they do?
You meet someone.
Out there or here?
Out there. You have to meet them a couple of times.
Always out there?
I think so.
Then what?
Then it's up to you.
How do they do it?
They use something called a bar.
It's okay.
They mix it with water.
I don't really know what to say.
You don't have to say anything.
No, I know, but I want to. I want to know what to say to you.
A lot of people apparently never go through with it.
How do you mean?
A lot of people, once they've been given the green night, once they've... A lot of...
It's okay.
They're happy enough knowing it's there.
How bad is it? Mary?
It's pretty bad.
How bad is pretty bad?
They said being under 40 might help.
Mary, how bad is pretty bad?
I'm not sure I want to talk about it right away.
Mary, I've been waiting around on tenterhooks.
I'm not sure I can talk about it right away.
Do you want something to drink?
Do you want some water?
No, thank you.
Do you want some booze? I mean...
I'm just after a moment's silence and then I'll tell you anything you want. He said, I think, something like a third of people live for a year.
What about the other two?
What?
What about the other two thirds? How long do they...
I don't know, Roland. I don't know.
What did they tell you? What did the...
I don't know. I can't remember. They gave me some leaflets. I mean, why does it matter what happens to the other two thirds?
Why does it matter?
Yes.
It matters because presumably we don't know which third you're going to be in.
Why are you being arsy with me? I just said to you...
I'm not being...
Yes, you're being arsy. You're getting mad at me for not remembering this number or that number. I mean, who gives a fuck?
All right.
I'll go upstairs and get my fucking handbag and you can rifle through the plethora of leaflets if it bothers you that fucking
much. All right,
much.
All right. I'm sorry. Did he talk about treatment?
He said they can operate. Try and remove it. Move as much of it as they can. Then he said radiotherapy, but if I'm too weak for radiotherapy, they said chemo. Shitload of chemo. It's right at the front.
The front?
It's all over the frontal lobe.
I don't know what that means.
He said I might have trouble selecting words. Selecting the right words. He said I should expect seizures.
Jesus Christ.
It's palliative. Whatever they do. It's not... They can't...
Okay.
They said this is it.
Okay.
This is it, they said.
Okay. Okay.
Why don't you sit down?
I need to sit down, do I?
Maybe. I mean, no, standing is fine.
I would have come with you if you'd told me, you know.
I know.
I would have cancelled...
I know. I wanted to go alone.
I'm a bit angry, actually, Mary.
Angry?
I'm saying so that you know.
You're angry?
I'm saying so that you know because I don't want to have an argument.
Glad to fucking hear it.
All right.
I'm sorry you missed out on the sheer joy that was collecting the results of my biopsy, Roland.
All right.
But forgive me, I didn't feel like inviting along a fucking entourage of onlookers.
All right, Christ. I'm telling you so I can get it off my chest because I want to be as honest with you as I possibly can. Because I don't know what you're about to say, but it's clearly bad news, and I want to be able to listen and not be thinking, I wonder what she did with herself once she heard. I wonder why she didn't call me straight away.
I would have dropped
absolutely anything and everything, and I wonder if she knows that.
So I got my biopsy results.
Today?
They called me and asked me to come in.
Who did you see?
Dr. Thorne.
What did he say?
He said it's benign.
What?
He said that it's a grade one, and he said that it's benign.
Wait, he said that...
He said that ordinarily, with a grade one, he would expect to see a full recovery.
Did he use that phrase, full recovery?
Exact quote.
He said...
Ordinarily, he would expect to see a full recovery.
Shit.
Yeah.
What happens now?
They need to operate.
But he definitely used the phrase, full recovery.
He did.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you hungry? Do you want some bolognese? Homemade?
Have we got any of the nice spaghetti? Oh,
I love you.
It's called a glioblastoma multiforme.
Right.
It's a grade four.
Right.
It's at the front.
Okay.
Which is why I've been having trouble...
Speaking.
He said he thinks they should operate.
Great.
He said he thinks that's what they should start with.
Great.
And then he suggested radiotherapy.
Okay.
But he said that if I'm too weak for radiotherapy...
Too weak?
Yes.
Okay, sorry.
He said that if I'm too weak for radiotherapy, then chemo is probably better.
Okay.
He said that...
We can stop.
No, I'm okay.
We could eat.
No, I'm fine.
Honestly, we can stop. We can eat.
I think I'd rather just get...
No, you're right.
I think I'd rather just get through it.
Absolutely.
It's a year.
A year?
Probably less.
It's probably less than a year.
He didn't say that, but...
They didn't say that?
I went online.
But they didn't tell you that.
They said we should talk about all of that when we next meet. But when I got back to campus...
Mary.
I know, it's stupid, I shouldn't have done it. I went on a forum.
A forum?
People had left these dedications to all these people they had known had died. There were pages and pages of them. Most of them were really wet and drippy. I got really fucking angry.
Angry?
There's so much bullshit.
You mean on...
When someone dies.
Right.
There's so much bullshit. When your time's up, your time's up.
Right.
Time. I mean, what on earth are they even talking about?
Why don't we...
She was a real fighter, was she? Well, she obviously didn't do a very good fucking job, did she?
All right.
Some of them had uploaded photos.
We should eat.
There was a photograph of a woman with God knows how many tubes hanging out of her. She was surrounded by these garish fucking balloons.
Some people like to give people balloons.
If you give me a balloon, I will literally garrote you.
Note to self.
And if you put a photo of me in a fucking forum, I will haunt the shit out of you.
No forums. Okay, let's eat. We should eat.
I think I'd like to go abroad.
What do you mean?
I'm not sure how much of a difference the chemo is really making.
Do you mean you're not sure or they're not sure?
I mean me. I mean I'm not sure.
Why? Why aren't you sure?
I went on to campus.
What do you mean? What for?
To have lunch with Melissa. I had another seizure.
What? When? Mary?
A couple of weeks ago.
A couple of weeks ago?
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me?
It's the words, Roland. It's becoming more and more tiring.
You mean speaking to me? The two of us is tiring, or you mean everything?
I mean everything.
I didn't realize.
I know.
I'm sorry.
I know.
I don't know what to do.
You don't have to do anything.
I want to help.
You are.
So when you say abroad, you mean abroad and not come back?
Potentially. Yes.
How does it work?
You become a member.
A member?
Pay some money.
How much?
I don't know what it is in pounds.
Then what?
If you're serious, you write to them.
Meaning what?
Outline why they ought to be taking you seriously.
And if they do?
You meet someone.
Out there or here?
Out there. You have to meet them a couple of times.
Always out there?
I think so.
Then what?
Then it's up to you.
How do they do it?
They use something called a bar.
It's okay.
They mix it with water.
I don't really know what to say.
You don't have to say anything.
I know, but I... want to. I want to know what to say to you.
A lot of people apparently never go through with it.
How do you mean?
A lot of people, once they've been given the green light,
It's okay.
They're happy enough knowing it's there.
How do you know that?
It's on the website.
When you say a lot, how many are we talking?
I think it was something like 2/3. Safety net for a lot of people.
And is that what you're feeling about it?
I don't know.
Would I be able to come with you?
Would you want to come with me?
Would you want me to come with you?
Of Mum.
In what way?
Before she died.
Right.
When she said she didn't want any more food.
Yeah.
Do you remember?
I'm not sure we ever really talked about it.
I thought we did.
Bits and pieces, maybe.
Well, she said she wanted them to stop the IV. Did we talk about that?
I think maybe we did, yeah.
They asked me to leave. I went back the next day and she was starting to look like a ghost. It takes an enormous amount of strength when you're like that to keep going. I'm not sure I have it.
You don't know. You don't know that.
Sinking feeling.
Mary, listen to me.
I'm so tired, Roland. Before people had face... Before they had... Face. Before they fuck.
Okay.
God. People's lives were their own before it became skin. Skin. It became skin.
Skin?
Mum wasn't scared of dying. She was scared of being kept alive, you know?
Yes.
That wasn't what scared her.
I understand.
It's not just the speaking.
Okay, now I don't understand.
Reading. I'm having trouble. Numbers, words on the page. I don't know how to explain it. Typing as well.
In what way?
I know the word I'm trying to type, but I don't know the letters. None of the letters seem right. Ria.
You don't need to finish.
I want to.
I think I know what you're trying to say.
How? How can you know what I'm trying to say? Most of the time, I don't even know what I'm trying to say.
You're right. I was being polite because I don't want you to wear yourself out.
Maybe we should get me a notepad to hang around my neck?
What?
Kidding.
Oh, Mary fucking hell.
Roland, I don't think that I can go back to work.
Have they told you that?
They're great.
You've told them then?
Not yet.
But you're going to?
I think so.
But you haven't said any of this to them?
They've said whatever I want.
So what about part-time?
I don't know the point.
You mean the point of going part-time?
I either do it or I don't. Scares me.
Work?
Stopping.
Stopping work scares you.
What will I do?
We'll go away. We can do whatever we want.
I don't...
I'm being serious.
I don't...
I mean it.
I don't... We can't. I have to... I have to have a choice. Control.
Taxi's booked for 9.
I know.
Gives us an extra half an hour.
It does.
Are you tired?
A bit.
Would you like to go to sleep?
What time is it?
Are you hungry?
Not particularly.
We could order some room service.
I'm fine.
Taxi's booked for 9.
I know.
Gives us an extra half an hour.
It does.
Are you tired?
A bit.
Would you like to go to sleep?
What time is it?
Are you hungry?
No.
We could order some room service.
I'm fine.
Taxi's booked for 9.
I know.
Gives us an extra half an hour.
It does.
Are you tired?
A bit.
Would you like to go to sleep?
What time is it?
Are you hungry?
Not particularly.
We could order some room service.
Full.
Do you want to put the telly on?
No, thank you.
I've had a really wonderful day.
Same.
Really?
Yes.
Can I be honest with you?
No.
There are times when I look at you and I absolutely understand why you're doing this. But there are times when I absolutely don't.
And I'm not saying you shouldn't be calling it a day. But I suppose I'm starting to wonder if now is the right time. Because if it were me and I were you, I think I would want as much time as possible. And if you think you've got another couple of months in you, God, I would love to give that a go.
Yes.
What?
Yes. Let's go home.
Because if it were me and I were you, I think I would want as much time as possible. And if you think you've got another couple of weeks in you, God, I would love to give that a go.
What do you mean by time?
Time. I mean time. I'd want more time. With you.
I'm not sure that you and I, we think that, but that there's an arrow from past to present.
Mary.
But that's really all we can say. Asymmetrical.
Mary.
But nobody knows why.
Okay.
Listen to me, please.
Let's not talk about this now.
Please.
I shouldn't have brought it up.
Listen to me, please. The basic laws of physics. The basic laws of physics don't have a past and a present. Time is irrelevant at the level of atoms and molecules. It's symmetrical. We have all the time we've always had. You still have all our time. Once. There's not going to be any more or less of it. Once I'm gone.
Hello, Marianne.
Roland. Wow. Hi. Hello. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks.
Oh, good. Good. That's really good.
How about yourself?
I bought some of your honey.
You did?
From the Budgeons in Crouch End.
Yeah, right. They're really great.
I said to the girl on the till, I said, I used to know the man who made this honey.
What did she say?
She just stared at me.
I read one of your papers.
You did not?
I did. I downloaded it.
That's really amazing, Roland.
What did you think of the honey?
Delicious. It was completely delicious. Are you here for the ballroom class?
Yeah. No, yeah. I am, yeah.
Really?
Heather's getting married in a couple of months, so...
The PE teacher?
That's right, yeah. Good memory. I've been ordered to sort out my two left feet or else. How about you?
Similar, really. Wedding.
Your own, or...?
No, God, can you imagine? I'm being a very diligent bridesmaid. We're having some kind of mass Viennese waltz. I'm not sure I fully understand it as yet.
So is this your first lesson?
No, second. You?
First, yeah.
Well done on the comfortable trouser front. I came straight from work. Last week, crotch was like a blazing hothouse by the time I got home.
We should... Afterwards, if we're not both completely exhausted, there's a nice place not that far. We could try going for a drink. But if we're there and you change your mind, if you change your mind and you want to call it a day, then we'll just call it a day. We'll just call it a day and you never have to see me again.
Constellations, Marianne was played by Gugu Mbatha-Raw and Roland by George Mackay. The director was Sasha Yevtushenko.